There's nothing more satisfying than at the end of the day, after you've been in the garden, planting, weeding, or mulching, sitting back and on your patio and looking at all your labor of love and having a cup of tea and enjoying nature. So that's why I included in this Victorian garden a Victorian teacup. This is drawn from my collection of teacups that my mother started me on. So it's very simple to put together. I like to pick a double-sided paper. And what I've put on here is that ultra-thick embossing powder to make it look like china. Now, one more thing I add to mine, because my Victorian cups all have this little bit of gold to them. So I'm using these metallic rub-ons. You know, they still make these. And I'm going to add that little bit of gold around the rim and on the handle, and then around the saucer. Just gives it that elegant look. This will be the container for my camellia that I'm going to show you. Another flower from the Victorian garden. In fact, its meaning is, my destiny is in your hands. So how appropriate. There we go. Now let me just clean this up and put it on my project, and we'll start with the camellia. So as before, with some of my planters and vases and the wellies, I like to put a little foam pad behind it so it raises across there. And then just, I don't know, this is by accident that it happens. When you use the ultra-thick embossing powder, my saucer does kind of sit up so you can see the dimension. It really does look like it's sitting on the table here. So I'm just holding that in place to catch that glue there. I've left it open up there so I can put flowers in or greenery. So I'm going to set this aside, and we're going to start on the camellia. Just there. Going to set something heavy on top of it. Anyway, so on the camellia, you've got three pieces here. You've got the larger petals, which I say to cut three times, and then you've got a plate here with three different sizes, and you're going to cut that twice. And then you've got your leaves, two to three times, so that would be either four to six leaves. Again, this is a shrub. And it does bloom, some varieties bloom from November to April. So in some places, like here in North Carolina, we have beautiful pink blooms in the wintertime. Although we've had some really cold spells, and some of my buds have really browned on the edges. Anyway, before we get started on doing the flowers, there's some prep work to do on some of the other things. So like the magnolia, these leaves are also very shiny and have a thickness to them. That's what helps them to withstand some of the harsh winters in places, especially if you plant this like I do. It's in an area that's closer to my house, in a bed where it doesn't get direct sunlight, but it does get some morning sun. And then it also has the protection of the home. So on those cold nights, you know, it's getting a little warmth radiated from it. But they do have these thick, kind of waxy leaves. And so we're going to go ahead and color this. And I'm using, again, that YG8.5 and YG8.7 to color them. Now, these get stem lines, so I'm going to bring in my leaf pad here and my leaf tool. Oops. And run a stem line right on the wrong side. So I've got it right side facing down, and I'm going to bend on it. And then I'm going to bring in the Pan Pastel, and this is the brightest green, because I really want to accentuate that stem line. No leaves or no veins to this. So we're just going to go ahead and shape it by pinching it at the stem line, bringing up on it, and then using our medium ball stylus, I'm going to soften around that edges here a bit and scrunch that tip. So this is going to get some glaze. And I'm going to grab my plate here, put some glaze in it, and then grab a paintbrush. And so you just go ahead and paint your leaf. Give it that shine, that thickness that requires it. I'm going to give a little bit more to this one too. There you go. Right there. So nice and shiny. I'm going to set that aside. And then now we'll work on the flower. Now the coloring I did on this, they come in several colors. There's white, there's various shades of pink, all the way to a red. And there's six types of blooms. Now there's a single, what they call a semi-double, an anemone, a peony, a rose form double, and a formal double. I've given you kind of a semi-double here. But if you stay tuned, once this is released, I'm going to show you on my Facebook page, Susan's Garden Club, the different ways you can make this into other varieties. So I like the pink. That's the color I have by my house. I also really like the red, but this works well with my arrangement here. So I'm taking that little darker pink, that R5.3 by Olo, and then adding the 5.1 to shade it out. You can see where this does look like a rose sometimes. It's very different, though, as far as having the way the petals go up. What I'm going to bring in my other pen here. I've got to change that out, but I've got one that's always have a backup. I put the two different ones right on the, let me take this off, so I can flip back and forth. It makes it easier that way. So all of them were colored in the two different shades like this. If you were doing red, you would do pretty much the same thing. Maybe a little bit darker red towards the center as it gets intensified. Now I'm going to make a bud with this one, a separate bud that hasn't bloomed yet. It also gets a bud in the center. So I'm going to set that aside, and here's my bud. Let me work on that. So I cut two extra pieces from the main the plate here. I cut that large size or next to the large size. And on one of these, I want to do as if it's a calyx covering it. Now, I'm not going to go all the way up. I'll leave some of that showing, but I wanted to have green underneath like that. So if we bring in our molding pad, and let's work on these pieces first. These are smooth petals, you know, as opposed to the rose, where you can get some striations. So I'm using the ball styluses to smooth these, just like I did on the magnolia. do this one here. And then we're going to do these. These I'm just pushing forward, not so much rounding them as I am getting them to curl inward, because you want that tighter bud towards the center. Okay, so all of these get treated the same way. I'm going to just pinch these tighter towards the center a little bit. I've done it on these shapes as well as the very smallest ones here. Just a way of getting it more defined in the center using your reverse tweezers. And then I'm going to go for my small ball stylus and really cup that up. So this is going to be the underside one. Let me grab some glue. And I'm going to put this shape right on top. Let me turn this over. Whoops. There we go. And then I'm going to, see, I want to line that up this way. So you want to offset those petals. Press down. And then grab your little, I'm even going to turn some of these inward a little bit tighter. Put a little bit of glue right on that end there. And then inside. And then we'll grab this one and do the same thing. Again, I'm looking to offset it so it's not right on top of each other. You want that fullness in there. Now just go ahead with your hands and squeeze together. And we're going to grab that flower mold here. And I put that right into that smaller one there and let it set. So I finished this other one, and I'm going to put that right into my mold and let them set while we do the flowers. The one thing you want to do is grab your large ball stylus and let's change it out from the medium. This has a bigger surface and it really is easier. You won't have to work as hard. So starting with the larger petal, and there's five to the set, and it's the larger one, you're going to put it face down on your molding mat. And I'm going to start going around it. I'm doing it kind of a reverse way of the way I would do a rose, where I have that right side up. This is wrong side up. And you're just going to go around all these petals. Like I said, we'll explore how to do the other varieties, and it won't be too much to change them out if you like, you know, a different variety. Now I'm going to take my small ball stylus and cup that up, set it aside. So I'm going to repeat it on these two and these two here. I want to show you something on these next two layers for the large one. I did that one. We're going to repeat with this last one. So there's three to this flower. And again, I'm shaping it with the large ball stylus face down, just like I did the first two. And the reason why I put the large ball stylus on the opposite end of my leaf tool, I'm going to use my leaf tool to pull that right to the center. So you're going to go about maybe a quarter of an inch and pull up and push towards the center. So you still have your petals facing downward. And then we can go ahead and give it a little crunch there. You're going to do the same with these two. These are the four petal ones. And again, just go ahead and go around them with the large ball stylus. You want that smooth petal look that you can create with that, with this tool. And then you're going to flip it over and use that leaf tool about a quarter of an inch and push down. I'll do this one and then we'll put our flower together. One last thing, if you find you've got too much ruffling around, just go around with your tweezers. And I'm just grabbing the edge and kind of pulling down on it to take away some of that ruffle. I want it kind of smooth. I want it shaped in the middle, but I don't want it to look wrinkly. So you can grab those and just go around each edge if you find you have too many gathering marks. You can even pull up a little bit on it to curl it back the other way, just to make it look a little more natural too. Okay, and then I'm gonna, lastly, after I've done that, put it together. So we have our project. I'm gonna grab the larger petals first. And just put some, right, in the center there. I'm going to set this down. I'm going to go with the next layer. You have that little point there. And again, I'm always offsetting, so I'm going to put that right there in between. Last large set of petals. I really hold that down a bit. This is a lot of bulk, and so you want to make sure your glue gets firmly in place there. So now we're going to offset this. And then the last one here of the large petals, or the next large rather. And you can see how this looks so much different from a rose, even though a lot of people might mistake it for one. It is a camellia. And then I'm going to grab that bud that we had setting in our flower tray here, our mold tray. I'll put some extra glue on that and set them right down in the center. Make sure it locks in place. I like to make sure this is pulled around a bit, so you can always go back and play with this. Make sure they're kind of concentric. There we go. Perfect. I'm going to add a few leaves. Just, whoops, I don't want to drip right under there. These shiny leaves just, they really are so pretty and elegant looking. But I need some color contrast. So let me show you. Oh, I'm going to add the bud, I think. Can I add that now? Let me see. So I've got that bud that I think I'll add over here. And what I'll do is put, I'm going to lay out a leaf just a little bit beyond the others and then grab. And you can see how I just painted a little bit of that green on the pink to make it look like the calyx. And then I'm going to lay that down this way. There we go. So while that's drying, I want to show you, I'm going to add some ginkgo leaves. The ginkgo is a beautiful tree and is bright green to, as it goes into the fall, goes gold and then all gold. It's beautiful. So I've got one that's just starting to turn, and I'll show you how I got this coloring. The ginkgo actually stands for longevity, and it also stands for hope and peace. So it's nice to add to it. It is a tree, so we've got the branch here. I'm doing it in Y8.7 in Olo. I'm going to go on the back side here as well. They start out in the spring in a bright green, but then the ends start to fade to yellow and then go all gold. So we're going to grab, where's Y2.5? There it is. So again, I'm going to add two colors. And this is what I've done before. I don't want so bright. I want it to start, you know, darken it a bit. So I'm taking a little bit of the 8.5, the YG8.5, and laying it on my glass mat here. And then I'm going to pick that up and add it into my Y2.5. Now I'm going to just go just not quite to the end. And add that nice bright green that it starts out to be. This will give us nice contrast with our project. I'm going to turn this over and do this side. Since I'm not going to be blending the gold into the, or the yellow into the green, I don't have to go back and do this right away with blending, because I want that gold to be on the edges. I don't want it to be a yellow gold. I want it to be gold. I will take that Y2.3 and add that color on the edges. My hand's got a little bit of pink on it. There's three different foliages now in the Victorian garden foliage. So you've got your lemon verbena, you've got your ginkgo, and you've got a new variety of eucalyptus to play with. Okay, grab your leaf tool on your leaf mat and go ahead and let's go over some lines here. I'm not going to really darken them. I'm just trying to accentuate them. So with the right side facing down, go over it. And don't be afraid to go ahead and bend them, because when you bend it back up, you're going to get that nice line in there. So I'm just using my hands here to bend on that line. And then I'm going to take This is just a fine pen in an olivey green. I'm going to add some just striations in this. Just a little bit darker olivey green, just so you can see that those striations of the leaf. And depending on what season your ginkgo is in, would determine, you know, what color striations you would use. Now if I go back and bend up on those lines, I'm getting that nice vein, stem line. Go this way. And I've also used the watercolor paper for this foliage as well. I like them a little thicker so they really stand up. Okay, so I'm going to add these ginkgo leaves here to give it some height and contrast color. Let me grab my, there. And then I also, from the painter's garden, did a little bit of Carolina allspice, because the allspice stands for compassion. So if I was to give you this bouquet, this, I would have in it, my destiny is in your hands. I hope you have longevity and wish for hope and peace and compassion. So let your flowers speak to you and enjoy this beautiful Victorian garden. I know I do.